And so foodborne illness is sort of the first section that we're going to talk about today. There are cases all over the place, and unfortunately, we deal with this a great deal, at least on a weekly basis, and sometimes multiple times in a week, where our clients will get an angry phone call or an email or anything from somebody who says, I ate at your restaurant 3 hours ago, I'm very, very sick, you made me sick, I want money, or I want something, I want my doctor bills, I had to miss work today. Any number of things. And what's frustrating is, and where it becomes difficult as the practitioner, is that we're all cause and effect people. If you get sick and it's a couple hours after you ate at a restaurant, you and I both are going to immediately sort of make an association that the last place that we ate is a place that resulted in our illness, although it's very rarely the case. So most foodborne illnesses take up at least 6 hours. 4 to 6 hours is the minimum, absolute minimum incubation sort of ramp up period before you get sick. And normal people, just sort of regular lay people, don't know that. It's an immediate cause and effect reaction. And they're going to email or Yelp or tweet or all of those things, TripAdvisor, they're going to go throw their bad review out there and send you a nasty email. And what they're not going to do is go to the CDC and pull the full foodborne illness chart and realize it could have been something that they had eaten 3 weeks ago. I mean, if they have E. coli, it isn't necessarily going to happen that day. It will not happen that day. And so that's something that you have to deal with when you're practicing in this area, is how does your client address that? So contaminated food can cause foodborne illness, contaminated workspace, contaminated people. And you have to have a client that understands that this can result in either one incident, which could be bad, or a widespread outbreak, which could be incredibly bad. I mean, if you know anything about this particular practice area and you don't know what happened at Chipotle, its sales are down 15% year over year because of the catastrophic effect that two foodborne illness outbreaks had on its stock price over the last year and a half or so, back from sort of mid to late 2015. The ramifications are still being felt in that company.